Hey, what's going on? So, I had a couple questions about the first generation Orient Mako. So, this is from 2011. I saw a TGV, or the Urban Gentry YouTube channel, talking about these, and it's pretty popular on like 4chan and stuff like that. I wore this one in college for a little bit. This is on a horror bean band, Shell Cordovan, Oxblood. So I had that custom made for this particular watch. So the first generation watches do not have sapphire crystals. These are just standard mineral glass right here. And then they included this weird little pressure system. So what you would do is you'd hit this pusher to move the day function while this did the date and time. Still had the unidirectional bezel. However, it is not as gorgeous or like smooth as the current issue or the Mako XL or the higher end Makos. This was about $120 in 2011. Got it off of Amazon. Ships on a standard rubber strap, but I've long since got rid of that. It was cheesy back then. Like they're better now, but they're super cheesy back then. What everyone was doing is putting them on these NATO straps. They're called Real NATO, I guess is what the colorway was. This one's from Meritac, which is a long gone brand. That is, they're not in business anymore, but they used to sell like watch straps and whatnot. I think they had like an off brand mechanical movement watch. It was like $500 or something like that. It was like a pilot style. So that's what these straps were originally for. It's a 22 millimeter. So you can see I wore this one quite a bit in college. So before, you know, Apple Watches and Fitbits and all that came around, so yep, this was it. Mechanical. It's like 21.6 beats per hour. Pretty slow. Not super smooth. I haven't worn this one in a good while. So, it's a quick little overview.